Bonjour tout le monde. Je suis ici aujourd'hui avec la vice-première ministre Freeland et les ministres Blair, Lametti et Mendicino. Je veux commencer par remercier le commissaire Paul Rouleau et tous les gens qui ont participé et travaillé pour faire aboutir le rapport de la Commission sur l'état d'urgence. We were very clear from the beginning that invoking the Emergencies Act included the launch of a public inquiry to look at how and why we got there. This was an essential step to ensure transparency and accountability. During the inquiry, I welcomed the opportunity to appear and to answer the Commission's questions, as did all my colleagues. The work of the Commission and everyone involved was very important, not only to better understand what happened a year ago, but to have a roadmap going forward for any future government. Today, the Public Order Emergency Commission stated that the very high threshold to invoke the Emergencies Act was met. He found that what we experienced last year was a national emergency that threatened the security of Canadians. Our job as a government is always to keep people safe, and invoking the Emergencies Act was the necessary thing to do to remove the threat and to protect people. We've all been through a lot over these past years. Canadians have been stressed, faced real financial challenges, and lost loved ones. Many people came to Ottawa because they were hurting and wanted to be heard. In our country, everyone has the right to protest peacefully. That's a fundamental right that government will always defend. Here in Ottawa, people are used to political activity and protests on Parliament Hill. But as the Commissioner said, lawful protests descended into lawlessness, culminating in a national emergency. Streets were blockaded in our capital city for weeks, causing serious harm to families and small businesses. Aux frontières, à plusieurs endroits du pays, les barrages nuisaient à notre économie et mettaient en danger la sécurité publique. Par exemple, à chaque jour au pont Ambassadeur, c'est 300 millions de dollars de marchandises qui transitent entre Windsor et Détroit. Des milliers de personnes, de familles et d'emplois dépendent de la circulation de ces marchandises. Le fait de bloquer ce pont était tout simplement inacceptable. Ce barrage mettait en péril le commerce avec les États-Unis, les chaînes d'approvisionnement essentielles et l'économie canadienne. And at Coutts, in Alberta, guns were found at the blockade. There was a real risk that people promoting ideologically motivated violent extremism could act out, or that they could inspire others to act out against their fellow citizens. The situation was volatile and out of control. The Emergencies Act provided us with more tools to safely bring the illegal blockades and occupations to an end. Let's be clear. We didn't want to have to invoke the Emergencies Act. It's a measure of last resort. But the risk to personal safety, the risk to livelihoods, and equally, the risk of people losing faith in the rule of law that upholds our society and our freedoms, those risks were real. Responsible leadership required us to restore peace and order. Après avoir entendu des douzaines de témoins, après avoir étudié les documents nécessaires, la Commission sur l'état d'urgence a indiqué que l'année dernière, on faisait effectivement face à une urgence nationale. Et le seuil très élevé à respecter pour invoquer la loi sur les mesures d'urgence a été atteint. Ces mesures ne devraient jamais être prises à la légère. Depuis le début, notre gouvernement était confiant que c'était une décision responsable et on savait qu'il y aurait une commission d'enquête pour assurer d'être transparent pour les Canadiens. The report provides a comprehensive, objective account of what happened, and it also provides recommendations. Within the next year, our government will issue a comprehensive public response to the Commissioner's recommendations. On est tous d'accord qu'on n'aurait jamais dû en arriver là. Et on est tous d'accord qu'il y a des leçons importantes à tirer pour tous les gens impliqués. Because of the thoughtful work of the Commission, there are lessons for everyone involved, law enforcement agencies, all orders of government, and elected officials. We will take seriously what the Commissioner concludes and what he proposes. Responsible leadership means that we are always striving to do the very best for Canadians, in words and in deeds. Il y a deux jours, c'était le jour du drapeau canadien. Il y a 58 ans, l'unifolié a été hissé sur la colline du Parlement pour la première fois. Chaque fois que je vois notre drapeau, je vois des valeurs comme l'ouverture, la compassion. 2 days ago, it was Flag Day. We celebrated the fact that 58 years ago, the maple leaf was raised over Parliament Hill for the very first time. When I look at the Canadian flag, I see hope. I see people who work hard every day. I see a country that has overcome tremendous challenges. There's a reason why Canada is one of the most successful democracies in the world. It's because we work at it. It's not always easy. Actually, sometimes it can be pretty hard. But it's worth it. Here in Ottawa, this Parliament, the Senate, the Supreme Court, these are not only old buildings. They're the institutions that protect our rights and freedoms. This is something we must all continue to care for and defend. Not just governments, not just elected leaders, but all Canadians. Our democracy is the responsibility of all of us together. A healthy democracy is always going to make us stronger, especially in this moment of change and global uncertainty. So let's be there for one another. Let's listen to and respect each other, even if we don't always agree. And let's continue to build a better future for all Canadians. Merci beaucoup.